Hello. This is Joppa Radio 96.3 FM. I am joined today with Ken Irwin, and we're going to be talking about a dervish who is playing at the Belleville stage at the Belleville Church, which is 300 High Street on, is it this Saturday the 2nd?
This Saturday, yep. 8 o'clock.
And we were talking earlier a bit before the show. This is their third time playing here in Newburyport at the Belleville.
Right. They've been Belleville favorites for sure. And each time we've had more and more people coming. So I guess a lot of people agree and feel that they're favorites also.
Great. So they, for people who don't know, Dervish is they're an Irish band, right? They're
right.
From Sligo County?
Yeah, County Sligo.
County Sligo, my bad. They've been around.
Same words, just different. The way that they do that, yeah.
Yeah, different order. I was looking it up too. I was like, it's spelled Sligo, and I thought maybe Sligo. No, Sligo.
Yep.
So they're from Sligo.
County Sligo.
County Sligo.
Yeah,
I'm gonna get it. And
it would be like, you know, like you're located on Street High.
Yeah, it's Street High, County Sligo. Okay, there we go. So they've been around, I think, since they've at least had an album since, I think, the early 90s. I think I was looking at it, maybe 90.
The first record was actually 1989, but they were the boys of Sligo at that point.
And they didn't have, is it Kathy Jordan?
Yeah, Kathy joined a few years later, and they did their first record as Dervish in 1993. And they've only had, after Kathy joined, there's only been one edition, and they've had the same band, which makes it really easy for posters or, you know, or press. And, you know, you don't have to, well, who's in the band now?
Like, who is this? So, actually, I can show this right now, the poster.
Sure.
And we can talk about it more, too. So, let me see, where is the camera? I don't know. I hope that picks it up. I think it does. So I'm counting. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6 members on this poster.
Right.
And are there any additional members that weren't there over the years? I know we just talked about Kathy Jordan. She joined back in the 90s.
And then Tom, the fiddle player, joined in 1998. And he's the most recent addition. So everybody's...
They've known each other.
Been in the band, yeah. They knew each other before, most of them. There's a tradition in Irish music, not too dissimilar from bluegrass, where you'll have jam sessions, mm-hmm. but theirs are usually based around a pub. And, you know, people just get together and drink and eat and play and play and drink and eat.
And dance, too, I'm assuming.
And, yeah, and dance. And, the great time, and they got to know each other informally, and then later on they had an opportunity to make the record and brought them all together, and they all liked it, and the record got a fair amount of attention, and the second one definitely did, and it's continued. They, you know, travel from continent to continent and, you know, building up followings all around the world.
Yeah, so I've just got their... Wikipedia article up earlier because I was reading it. I know they've gone all over. They have a bunch of albums. They were also in the Eurovision Song Contest in 2007. I saw.
Right. They've done things like that from time to time. They entered one contest real early on and didn't do too well. And they're fierce competitors and kept on, and they've evolved into one of the best bands out there, especially with a traditional bass, and with the Chieftains getting older and not touring so much, Dervish is poised to become the traditional Irish band to see. And they, you know, they come over here every year during Green Month, which is March.
Okay.
And I saw a little question mark in your head there.
Took me a moment there. I got it.
And so they've been coming over for decades now. This is, you know, from the very first record, it's actually their 30th anniversary.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was seeing that they, I think it was on your website, actually. They were following the Prime Minister? Or they were endorsed by the Prime Minister, or they got an award from Sligo County, or it could be both.
Yeah, I mean, they've been very close to the prime minister and many other people around there, just, you know, politicians and writers and, you know, just, you know, been embraced by the whole Irish community. And, you know, they're very, very proud to be Irish and love to be spreading the music and tell stories, which... you know, unfortunately, we don't have anything but that we can play. But Kathy Jordan is one of the best MCs I've ever seen. She's funny, really a wry sense of humor, and very knowledgeable about the music, gives great background descriptions of the songs, where they came from, and, you know, makes them... really come to life, even the murder ballads. And I don't think I think they make the murdered people come to life.
No, but, they're very dead. So when you're talking about her being very knowledgeable about the music as well, so do they play a mixture of traditional Irish songs and their own, or is it?
They don't write many many songs, but they do from time to time take more contemporary songs, like a Bob Dylan song or mm-hmm. Richard Thompson song, and dervishize them. I don't know if that's the proper way, but I think it gets the point across. And yeah, I mean, they've, over the years, I think they've made 14, 15 albums. I lost track.
There's a bunch on there.
Yeah. They've done a lot, but their heart's really in the traditional music. And their next record, which we'll play a little bit of later, is called The Great Irish Songbook. And for that, they've taken some of the oldest songs and had contemporary versions done by people like Vince Gill, who's, you know, won all kinds of Grammys and hosted country music shows and played with everybody. Abigail Washburn, who with Bela Fleck won a Grammy 2 years ago with folk, and Rhiannon Giddens, who won 2 Grammys 2 years ago, is on it. And Brandon Gleeson, who was in the Harry Potter movies.
Well, who did he play?
Oh, he's one of the older guys with a weird eye.
Oh, he's Mad-Eye Moody?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
My.
Oh, I love that. And he's a really wonderful fiddle player, but he's also a great Irish singer. And... who knew?
Wow, that is a great. That's a great visual right there.
So it's Steve Earle is on the album. So we'll get to hear a little bit of that later on. But why don't we play a little bit of music to give an idea? We'll get a something up tempo, fast instrumental, and this is from their current album, not the one coming out. It's called The Thrush in the Storm, and the tune is called The Green Gowned Lass.
All right, so just give me 1 second, I'll get it going. So that actually was the Rambling Irishman. That was my bad.
Right, and that is Kathy, and that's from the new album. It's a real old-time song that, again, they've updated.
All right, here we go. Take two. This mm-hmm. is The Green Gown Glass, and this is a little bit farther into the song, and you said it's a bit more up-tempo right here?
Yeah.
Okay. And here we go. Thank you. So that was very, I don't know if I know my Irish music terminology, but that felt much like a jig.
It's very Celtic.
Yeah, it was very lively.
So what you heard there is fiddle and accordion and flute and mandola and bouzouki and bodhran, the sort of hand-hit equivalent of a drum.
Was that...
That's what Kathy plays.
Drum here?
Yeah.
So for people that want to see, I don't know if you can see it.
Yeah, and that picture might look a little bit like a banjo head, but...
It's a drum.
It's a drum.
All right, yeah. So they do... Let's see, what do they have on this? They have... I see the mandolin. I see the fiddle. I see the...
It's probably a mandola, which is a
baritone.
It's a lower registered instrument, very similar with paired strings, and then the bouzouki.
That's over here on the left. It also is it? It's a string instrument,
yep,
right?
Mm-hmm.
There's
you know no electric instruments and no actual drum kit, but very, very solid rhythm section and great soloists. And the band is based on the two main pillars, the instrumental wizardry of the lead players and a great rhythm section, and then the hauntingly beautiful singing of Kathy Jordan and her humorous introductions. And it's a great, great, great band to see. Very varied in what they do, and they just play at a very, very high level. I think there's something that comes with being together for 30 years that
I think
probably helps a wee bit.
The chemistry and the...
But they still love it, which is great. They're really passionate about it.
That's what you want.
Yeah.
Would you want to hop to another song? Maybe one where we can hear Kathy singing?
Okay. If we're going to do that, we'll... go well. Let's go. Are you in reverse order still?
I can go in any order now.
Okay.
Now
why don't we play On Raglan Road, if you can find that?
I got you.
And On Raglan Road, to my mind, a beautiful, beautiful version with Vince Gill, who's generally thought of as a country singer, doing a song that you would think is an Irish person, you know, except for the accent. But all the people who joined on the album fit in. I've heard lots of albums that are tribute albums where a lot of the performances you just think, why did they ask this person? Oh, they must be a big seller or something. But everybody that's on this album really got it. You know, they really tried to get as much into the Irish mood and, you know, and place. And I think Vince did a beautiful job on this.
All right, so this is On Raglan Road. So that was about a minute snippet of Raglan Road.
What a voice.
So he isn't Irish, or is? No, he isn't.
Not to the best of my knowledge, no.
It's pretty convincing.
Yeah. No, that's, you know, everybody really brought it. There was no one who came in and did something that was totally inappropriate or even close to inappropriate. It was just a, I think we were really fortunate, but also I think we thought about, who would be good for the album and tried to find songs that would match the particular artist, and the artist just really came through.
So did you work with them on the album? Like, at least arranging the album, or?
I worked basically with Shane, who's the accordion player, and he's, I don't know if he's the in-house manager or if he's just the mouth.
He's the designated speaker.
He's definitely the designated speaker. And we discussed who might be appropriate for the record, who has an understanding and appreciation of traditional music and would, we thought, might fit in well with the project. And we went back and forth, and you know, we asked a number of people who really were very interested but couldn't for one reason or another. One person had had an operation on her voice or throat recently, and somebody else was on tour for a long time. And
wanted a break.
Yeah, it was... I think it'll be easier if we try to do a second one now that we have an album, and we can say, this is what it's going to sound like. Do you see yourself fitting in? So we're looking forward to that, but I think we're just, at this point, looking forward to getting it out, which will be in the next month or so.
Okay, so...
Yeah, to the second month, yeah.
In March?
Or April. Right, I think April. It's April. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
So we'll keep our eyes out for that.
Right.
But... do you want to play another song from the upcoming album, or should we play, do you want to play the other song from the current album?
Yeah, let's play Donald Og, which is Kathy, and it's a slow vocal, and it's from the Great Irish Songbook, but it's Kathy Jordan, who you will fall in love with if you come to the show.
Sounds like she's going to be a very, like you said, a very animated MC,
yes,
kind of lead. It sounds like captivating the audience.
Beautiful smile, reaches out, and just one of those people that they talk about who have it. You know, she just reaches out and
you can't define it, but
yeah,
she has
right,
it.
Yeah, she has it.
All right, well, let's hear a bit from Kathy. Right, so that was Donald Og, and we got to hear a little bit of Kathy there, along with everyone else. Very pretty. So again, let's talk about the event. So they're going to be this Saturday. It is what, 8 p.m.?
8 p.m. at the Belleville Church, which is 300 High Street, a corner of Chapel. And there's parking on the street for, I imagine most people are familiar with High Street. And we hear that the worst we're going to get is possible snow flurries. So we're, you know, the March or February shows, we get a little bit nervous, but it looks like we're going to luck out. And it's 8 o'clock. Tickets are available online at bellevilleroots.org. They're also available at the Belleville office, which is on Chapel Street, and that would be tomorrow and Friday, 9 to 1, and the Belleville Thrift Shop, which is open Saturday morning from 9 to noon, and at Dino Records downtown. We're glad that they're back involved after... you know, the change in ownership, and so we're excited about that. And like to thank the Institute for Savings and the Newburyport 5 cents savings for their support. Been very good, especially on the Irish shows. Something there's an actually pretty large population here. And when we ask people how many people have Irish roots, and about two-thirds of the audience goes up, it's really amazing.
Yeah, I mean, I actually don't know. Is Newburyport traditionally a big Irish community, or is it?
Not that I know of, but it just seems like
that's who comes out to the shows.
I don't know. Maybe it's certainly Boston is. So if you consider that over the years, a lot of people from Boston have moved up here, including myself. Not that I'm Irish, but I moved up here.
Made the trek up
from Somerville. Yeah.
Ooh, yeah. Very fun.
Big move.
Now, I don't know if you. At the shows, do you ever talk to the people and ask, like, have any of you come from far away, far away Boston, or has anyone come from maybe, a state over, two states over to come see the show?
We have people coming this time from South Shore, from numbers of people in New Hampshire, Springfield.
That's a hall. Far.
Yeah, I mean,
a couple hours.
You know, when you're bringing in really quality music, and people know about it, know the quality, they're willing to travel. You know, and they only come over during March, and I think this year they're going to come back not to Newburyport, but to the to do a tour with some of the guest artists, which will be really fun.
That sounds great. Would you like to play another song?
Yeah, this one, I'd like to play a little bit more of. This is one that's getting a lot of attention over in Europe. The BBC is playing Dervish's new record a little bit in advance. And this is a beautiful song. It's one of the few that's a little bit more contemporary. And singer is David Gray, who had some huge hits a little ways back. And not too long ago, about 2 years ago, I think he did a co-tour with Alison Krauss and played Boston and other markets. And it's a beautiful tune called The West Coast of Clare.
So that was a snippet of The West Coast of Clare. It's about 40 seconds right there. Very pretty. I would like to play more, but just for time's sake, I want to get all the bits going.
Right. I want to mention also that during intermission, there'll be a dance performance from students at the Bracken School over in Amesbury. And they've been doing this for a few years, and it's wonderful to see talented youngsters, but I think they range from like 4 till 20. So they have these different groups of real youngsters, and they're all dressed up in Irish attire. And
so some of these people have been doing it since they've been 4.
Yeah, they've been at it for a while, and it's great. It's great to see, because the dance is such an important part of that whole tradition with the music. So it's great to see. Trying to think what else. There's also food at intermission.
Is it Celtic?
It won't quite be Celtic, but it'll be good. They have a variety of things, but we're going to can't find it. sorry about that.
It's all good.
Yeah. We do have two other shows, one to mention for later in the season. The Seldom Seen, who are an award-winning band that's been around for years and years, and they were sort of groundbreakers in many sense in terms of bringing folk music into the bluegrass world. And they're coming in April. And then in May, we're having a return of Three Women and the Truth, which is Mary Gaucher. We have a poster up in the in the back.
Let me switch to that real quick.
Okay.
Oh, they can't see it.
Okay.
Ah.
And Eliza Gilkison and Gretchen Peters. All three have very successful solo careers. And then for a week or two every year, they get together and do these, you know, triple dates where they all get on stage and they swap songs and sing harmony on each other's songs. Ooh. And they're always involved in social issues. I think Mary's most recent record, which was nominated for a Grammy, was mostly co-writes with prisoners. And she went into prisons and, you know, worked with different people and telling their stories and, you know, helped them write songs. And it's a gorgeous album, and, you know, was, I think, very helpful in terms of,
So, yeah, do you want to play, just because of time's sake, do you want to play one more song?
Yeah, let's play another up-tempo instrumental from Thrush in the Storm, and this is called The Corner House.
So that was another jig then.
Yep.
Ooh. Very light, very kind of dancing, playful.
Toe tapping. Yeah, for sure. So I wanted to mention that we were talking before about the food, that we'll have fine desserts from Diane's Fine Desserts there, as well as the usual foods and drinks that we have at the show.
So again, this is Dervish. They'll be playing at the Belleville Roots on 300 High Street. Tickets are available from today, tomorrow, Friday, and Saturday.
In different places. Online at bellevilleroots.org, at the Bellevue office on Thursday and Friday mornings, and the Belleville Thrift Shop on Saturday, and Dino Records all day.
Mm-hmm. And parking on High Street and around the church itself. Can you park in Chapel?
Yep, you can park in any of those streets.
Okay, park on any
just
of those
try
streets.
To avoid people's driveways.
They won't thank you for that. So it starts at 8 o'clock, again, Saturday, March 2nd. Is there an open or anything?
No, we'd have two 45-minute sets, a lot, plentiful music, and then, as mentioned, an intermission, food, and the dancing from the Bracken students.
All right, yeah, so that sounds like a great time. Again, Institution for Savings, they are a sponsor, as well as Newburyport 5-Cent Saving Banks, who also sponsors the high school sports games. Just thought I'd mention that, if you guys didn't
good
know.
Community people.
Very
yep,
kind.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's going to be a great time. You should, if you're interested, go see it. 30 years of great traditional music experience. And, yeah, so Saturday.
And lots of fun.
Lots of fun, so. Yeah. Saturday, March 2nd.
Tell your friends and bring them along.
All right, and that'll be all.